This episode of Vic's Basement is brought to you by EB Games. Support us by buying your video games at EB Games.
Hi, welcome to Vic's Basement, everybody. Look, it's Scott Jones. He's here. He's got his leather coat on.
I got a lecture. He's going somewhere. Listen, I got to tell you, everyone, this. I shouldn't say this. This is something that happened in a pre-production meeting, but I got a lecture today about how far I hold my face from this microphone. So this is too far, maybe, is it?
Wow. We want to.
Is this too far?
Just sit normally.
If I sit normally, I'm still like 3 feet above the microphone.
Anywho. You're playing fast and loose with the term lecture.
It was a lecture. It was very stern.
It wasn't a lecture.
It was like a nun wrapping my knuckles.
Anyway, so you must have had a really great couple of weeks.
I did.
Yeah.
First, though, before we get into that.
What?
Well, I was on my way over here and suddenly I realized I had to poop.
Oh, no.
So I did a thing where I don't like to take all of my clothes off if I have to do a midday poop. So what I do is I just take off the lower clothes and... Anyhow, that's enough of that story. And now it feels like I have a piece of sand in there.
Oh, it's not like your ringing phone? What do you call it?
Yeah, it's like a phone ringing. It's just kind of...
that you need to pick up.
You shouldn't feel it. It should just be numb.
Uh-huh.
And then... And then it keeps reminding me that it's there. Am I too close?
Can you do me a favor, though? Can you, like, take your jacket off and stay a while?
I'm really cold.
Okay.
It's damp in the basement today.
it's damp
rainy weather.
Okay.
So did I tell my poop story?
I don't know. Are you done your poop story? You didn't get it. Did you go back into the washroom to do...
It was funny because it was surprisingly... it was surprisingly dramatic. You know what I mean? Explosions. Why are you reading that for? You have a human being sitting next to
us, and that everybody's good. They're just making fun of.
Are you not? Are you going to pay attention to this and not me all day?
No,
just like usual.
I just came back from.
Right on to your stories.
A European.
Yeah, here we go.
Adventure, and I brought you back some things.
Okay, I'll take it now.
Would you like to see those things?
Yes, no.
I just thought that maybe that would help.
Are they here?
They are here.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah, let's go. Let's do it.
Okay, great. I'm excited about this.
You're too far from the microphone.
Shut up. Oh, you're so annoying. Okay, so first.
What?
What's in here, Jones? Sorry about the crackling. For you. Smell.
Oh, thank you.
That is coffee from Stockholm. And this company, this place is called Cafe, but like K-A-F-F-E. And they get their beans made specially for them, so.
I am your father.
Don't breathe into it. You're tainting it. Anyway.
No, I'm not tainting it. This is what you should do with fresh coffee. Take a note, everyone.
Okay, I want to smell too.
Well, no, it's mine.
Can I smell it?
Maybe later.
Okay. Also, I brought something for Blake. Blake is here with us. Do you even not have a microphone, Blake? He
yes,
does.
I do.
Oh, okay. So, this is called Bublig. Mjolk chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's for Blake. Also, also something else for Jones, because Jones is gross. He likes those Good and Plenty's from America. So whenever we go to America, we try to get those Good and Plenty's because they don't actually have them here in Canada for some reason. Did you find them here in Canada?
No, they don't. I don't think they carry them here in Canada.
No. So Jones likes to get them when he's in America, or I'll get them for him if I'm there and he's not. So I got a version.
What was that one? You went to the States once and you bought Mounds.
I didn't buy Mounds because we have Mounds here. And I thought that you liked Mounds, but it was just a joke candy that you like because you like the name Mounds because it sounds sexual. But turns out he doesn't like Mounds, so don't bring him Mounds. He doesn't like anything.
All right,
with
so
coconut.
Far we've covered sex and poop and coffee and chocolate.
That's pretty good
the
first 5 minutes. Wait. Yeah. So this is called Lacrin Spinde.
Oh, very nice.
These are like the Good and Plenty of Sweden.
Okay.
Right?
You know, the irony is, like, this is so weird.
What?
But in high school, my nickname was Lacrin Spinde. That's what everyone called me, Lacrin Spinde. They're like, oh, here comes Lacrin Spinde. Oh, here he comes.
Oh, no, watch out. okay, so I have, this is from...
That looks like your birth control.
What the
That was gross.
So gross. Anyway, this is from the airport lounge in... so you know I always take something for free and I have to bring it to you. I can't just buy you
things. Oh, it's for me?
Yeah. So this is a shortbread cookie from the airport lounge in the UK.
This my Japanese thank you.
This is for you and Blake to share because there's two of them in
Blake
here.
Blake and I don't share.
This is called
We're
Dame.
Scott can have that.
Dime.
Yeah, thank
there's
you.
There's two. Okay, I'll have one then. There's two in here.
How about
this
if
is
you
another
Mojoco
Chocolade. That's how you say chocolate, I guess.
I guess that's not English.
No. And also, this is for us to share too. This is mint chocolate. Cola dopad something.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Chocolate.
I hardly believe you're Canadian. You speak Swedish so well now.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, great job. Who's this for?
Or you say tack. Tack is thank
who's
you.
Who's this for?
It's for us.
Oh, tack.
And this is for you.
Oh, this is my birth control.
That's your birth control. Oh my God. Also, okay, didn't realize this is in here, but I stole a hard-boiled egg from the breakfast room from the hotel in Sweden. I don't know, it was still in here. So you also get a
hard-boiled egg. I really don't want an old hard-boiled egg. Oh, that's sweet. Was I supposed to open it?
Yeah.
It's a snow globe.
Yeah, a Stockholm snow globe that you can put on the fridge. I couldn't find one that you couldn't put on the fridge.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess it's got a weird magnet
in
the back.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I know you probably don't like it now, but...
No, I still kind of like it.
Oh, you
do? I
don't
know if anyone's ever given me a snow globe.
Aw.
Usually I have to buy all my own snow globes.
Yeah, well, you like snow globes. So there you go.
Well, I don't like all snow globes.
So, face it this way. Anyway, so that's for you. I hope that cheers you up.
Lockridge Speed Aid to you.
Lockridge Speed Aid. Or you say, well, okay, we should have said Valkommen to Vic's Basement, because that's how you say welcome. I learned a few words. No, don't put that there. It's garbage looking. But for the most part, I just ate a lot of candy, and I bought a lot of candy, and I think that's the most important thing to do when you are abroad, is to eat all the candy that they have that we don't.
Yes.
Or all the food.
Well, you know, since we're talking about food,
yeah.
I'm going to say something. You're not going to like me for saying this, but before you left, you were counting calories.
Oh.
And
okay,
I warned you about going over to foreign countries while counting calories. It's very difficult.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you can see my body. I'm like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah.
And
is that why you're wearing the leather jacket?
Well, I count calories every
day.
No,
you don't. You lie.
But I knew it was going to be difficult. But you didn't. You stopped counting them, though.
Well, only because I had to.
And you turned your ship right into the candy storm that is any trip you go on.
I just want to live my life, though. I want to live my life. I don't want to restrict myself, especially when we're away.
We just have to let ourselves be fat. Why not?
I mean, my thing is that I don't want to buy new clothes. Like, I'd rather just fit into the clothes that I have. That's my main problem.
I'm fat and you're fat.
No, we're not. Don't say that. That's not true at all.
But we just got to be okay with our bodies, though. Like, there's so many parts of my body that I'm unhappy with, starting with the
beehole. With your penis. Oh, I was trying to say
why
penis.
Did you say my penis right away?
You usually disparage on your penis.
It's
so like
gross.
It's like a button on a
penis. Anyway, may a piece of sand crawl into your butthole. And a Lockridge Speed Aid.
And a Lockridge Speed Aid to you. Okay, so I know you don't want me to talk about myself, so why don't we talk about the things that you've done while we've
like
been away.
Well, I feel like you had a few minutes, so I would like to get...
I was giving you gifts in those few minutes.
I would like to get back to me.
Okay, go.
Anyway.
You saw a movie.
I saw several movies. I saw two movies.
Okay.
I did not see The Intern, which I believe is in theaters today. So okay. we don't have a review of that.
Uh-huh.
But
yeah.
I'm going to go ahead and review it anyway.
Yeah,
4 out of 10.
Black Mass is out, so you can talk about that.
I did review Black Mass.
The other one
won't air until next week,
yeah,
though,
so you
right?
can't talk about The Martian yet because it doesn't come out until next week.
I saw The Martian, and I have lots of thoughts on it.
Okay.
But I was given by this television show, EP Daily, 1 minute, and I had to do a review by myself. I asked Blake to do it, but he said, no, you're out on ice, and I hope the ice breaks underneath your feet and you go right in.
And did you?
No, I don't know. It's Ridley Scott. It's got Matt Damon with no shirt. You know, how do you not like it?
Oh, okay. So you liked it.
I don't know.
But you can talk about Black Mass, can't you?
I actually, of the two movies, I like Black Mass a little bit more.
Mm.
I'll be frank. I'm not going to review The Martian, but I'm going to make that one statement, and I hope Blake's okay with that.
Okay, what is it about Black Mass that you enjoyed?
It's based on a gangster named James Whitey Bulger. He's sort of a mythological figure in the Boston area, in the Southie neighborhood of Boston. So any movie where there's tons and tons of Hollywood actors, like Adam Scott, like Joel Edgerton, trying to do Boston accents, I'm already at a 6 out of 10. Now you got to give me the other 4 points.
Okay.
But you know, Johnny Depp has a lot of makeup on. He's kind of transformed. He looks like some sort of villain from one of the Harry Potter movies. I mean, his hair. I think he still has his hair in real life, though. When you look at any man in Hollywood, who knows?
Yeah,
who knows?
That's true. Yeah.
You know, the hair transplant is in right now. Vic and I have had them, and Marissa's thinking about getting one. So. So Johnny Depp has this bald wig on. I think it's a bald wig. Who knows? And he's got blue eye contacts in. Mm-hmm. And he has such amazing cheekbones. I feel strange saying that. But they just go, they're just like these, it's like a piece of farm equipment. You feel like you could use his face to make a little hole for plants to be planted. He's beautiful. He's a beautiful man.
Okay.
And I learned a little bit about Whitey Bulger, but I feel like the movie, and again, I'm not going to do a review, but I feel like anytime you do a biopic, you know, which is a movie based on an actual event or real life like this, it's hard to know where the facts and the fiction come together.
Sure.
And I wanted a really kind of relentless, gruesome gangster picture sort of in the... you know, even Donnie Brasco is, I think, a better movie than this. I really like Donnie Brasco. And Old Farm Plow Face is in that one, too. But Goodfellas is the movie that you can't help but, you know, not think of when you're watching this movie. And you're like, wow, I really wish this would kind of go off the rails. And I wish they would just have fun. And I wish they would beat up a guy and throw him in a trunk. Oh, wait, I think they do. And you know, I just want that kind of gangster shit, you know, that I'm used to seeing in movies. And
where they eat like some gabagool.
Yeah, maybe not that. We don't have to go that far.
No, really, because The Sopranos, that's the one thing that I didn't like was when they talked about Big City or gabagool. Like those are things that I've never experienced in my Italian culture.
I thought those were just words they were making up.
Yeah, I think that family in general just makes it up. Like it's not like to have meat like that on a plate. I don't know why you call it gabagool. I don't get that at all. And then a big ziti. My nana's never made that. So I think it's maybe like a Jersey thing. Could be like a Jersey Italian thing.
Welcome to the Italian American Heritage Minute.
You're not really Italian.
Yeah, you might not be Italian.
What? No, my family's Italian, I swear.
You smell like an Italian. Shazam!
Good one.
Anyway, that's movies in theaters. I don't know, go see it. Some coffee beforehand. There's a lot of people in it. There's so many actors in it. Like, again, it's kind of like The Martian, just an embarrassment of riches. Like, why are there no other movies being made in Hollywood?
Yeah.
Why is everyone... in these two movies.
Sure, yeah, of course.
Like, there's so many people in The Martian. Jessica Chastain, Michael Pena? I don't know how you say that. He's a nice guy. Pena. Michael Pena's in it. Kate Mara. Oh, I love her.
Yeah, you love her.
She's so little. She looks friendly.
Okay. I don't know.
I saw two movies. I went by one, The Martian, I saw with Blake, and Black Mass I went to by myself. True story, the people in the theater seeing Black Mass with me, I would say about 60% of them were over the age of 60, so a little older than me. And about 60%
really working for you.
About 60% of the 60-year-olds in there were asleep.
Aww.
One guy sitting next to me,
he
had a big cane in front of him and he just started going like this. Then all of a sudden I just heard...
That's a lie. That's not real.
That's what you do if you're over 60. You can't control. You can't. You don't have.
That happens to you sometimes, though.
It happened once. Just leave that straight.
No, it didn't happen once. It happened several times. Whenever you laugh, you fart.
Anyway, it's.
You fart a little
if
bit.
If it's a good laugh.
Yeah.
Thanksgiving, Canadian Thanksgiving is coming up, and also we have Halloween. So we'll talk about our Halloween costumes later. Why not?
Well, no, we have to discuss that with Vic.
Well, just make your own choices. Why do we have to get Vic's approval on everything?
No, I want a threesome thing going on.
I don't want that.
Okay, anyway.
I went to the movies. Blake, you have some comments.
Yeah, Gozer 3000, when you were talking about The Martian, wants to know, what game would you bring if you were stuck on Mars?
Hmm.
Bayonetta.
Really?
Yeah, why not? I don't know.
I don't know. I thought you'd say something else. Maybe Bloodborne.
Bloodborne.
Okay. I was certain it'd be Bloodborne.
What about, what would you bring if you were stuck on Mars?
Animal Crossing, for sure. Animal Crossing, for sure. Okay. Are you kidding me? That is like years of entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
Years. Once you finish Bloodborne, what's next for you?
Anyway,
exactly.
Let's just leave this conversation right here, okay? It's a little bit of a question mark, but that'll keep the people watching. But let's go back to you now.
Oh, great.
What games did you play when you were traveling?
Oh, my goodness. Well, Vic and I played some things that we reviewed. But you know what? I've discovered that I'm not... the only thing I really like playing while traveling on an airplane... No, I don't even... I bring my 3DS with me, but honestly, I'm addicted still to Fallout Shelter. And I'll just constantly go back to that, or also any kind of like management game where it comes to serving food. I don't know why. I have no idea why. But right now
it's
I'm addicted
you're a
to.
Waitress.
I was, yeah. So right now I'm
still
addicted
in your heart,
to.
You still
it's
are.
Like a Diner Dash type game. It's the same flow, like the same girl that stars in Diner Dash, but she's in her own. That's nice. She's in her own like restaurant game in the App Store.
What's her name?
So her name's Flo. So like you know, Flo's Diner. So I just played those two games. Like I hopped back and forth between those two. But on the flight back, I got into a heavy Downton Abbey marathon. So season 5 of Downton Abbey.
Is that one lady still alive?
Yeah, you like her, Michelle Dockery.
Oh, I do like her. She's got a, like her face, her features. It's like too small for the rest of the face around it.
Yeah, but I think you like that though.
I kind of like it.
Because you like relate to that for some reason.
Well, I just want her to have a flaw so I can be okay with my flaws.
Aw, that's sweet. She's
got beautiful hair.
She's beautiful hair. She's stone cold
though. What's her name?
Lady Mary.
Oh, wow. I like her.
Yeah, I know. She's great, right? So I got heavy into that. But yesterday was a full... I'm a little effed up right now. I just need to say.
Are you drunk?
No, but I feel like I'm on something just because I we were flying, like we literally traveled for a full 24 hours yesterday.
Poor so, you guys.
I know.
Jesus.
You got to sit in airports
with climate controlled air and play with your iPhones. Jesus Christ.
Anyway, I mostly just ate stuff. I feel like when I travel, I'm ravenous, like more ravenous than
normal. Have you tried these donuts?
I didn't. You know what? Well, I
go
didn't
ahead.
Have
let's
any.
Get, let's get into one.
Should we share one right now?
Yeah, go ahead.
Should we review a Swedish bar right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, go ahead. Six.
No, wait. We have to do it first.
Oh, I usually review the movies before I...
It's the candy bar is not embargoed. Yeah, so Vic
you
and
know,
I
think what? Matt Damon took one of those to Mars.
Oh, then he'd have been really satisfied. Yeah, so it's made in Sweden. Just I had to check every single bar or anything that I bought to make sure that it was made in Sweden before I purchased it. Or else, what is the point? And also, every store in Stockholm, everything has everything feels like IKEA. They live that IKEA lifestyle.
Mm.
So I do recommend Stockholm. It was a beautiful place. You're going to see a lot of Stockholm, actually, in EP Daily. We did a lot of shows
there. I
wish there.
I could... It's a good one, Blake.
That was good. I like
Don't tap on the thing. I wish I had my coffee maker here. I have a Mr. Coffee at home. I would make this coffee right now for us.
Okay.
It would be so delicious. It would smell just like we were in Sweden.
Mm.
Why do you eat such a small bite? Just eat one like
it
if you're
off.
Not on camera.
You know what this is like? It's like a score bar. Oh, but so much better. Okay. Well. This has a nice little bite to it. Yeah, like milk chocolate with them. It just looks like a score.
I don't think we can score until we eat more of it.
Okay. Oh, you like that. Mm-hmm. Okay. It just makes me feel so much better.
This is an 8.
It's so good. Okay. Okay.
You ate an 8.
Don't.
What?
Vic, we're not making a mess in your basement, I swear.
I just want that piece.
Okay. No.
Let's leave this out of here. Come on.
Why? I want to read what people are saying.
Who cares? Let's just stay together, you and me.
Okay. So, now that you have this, what is your collection up to now?
You're done?
No, I'm asking you.
I think that's all I have.
What? I thought you had a snow globe thing.
Nope.
So, what the hell? It was adding to your collection. You don't even have one.
You
all
come to my house. Have you ever seen any snow globes there?
Nope.
That's because they're all
I thought they were like you're
in a special climate-controlled storage locker.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, you can add
I don't have any snow globes.
Have you been to Stockholm?
No.
Where have you been around Stockholm? Have you been to like anywhere over there, like anything Scandinavian?
I've been to Denmark.
Oh.
I spent a week in Copenhagen.
Oh, that's very exciting. Did you buy chocolate there too or no? Because a lot of the chocolate also was in Denmark.
It was like 20 years ago when you were like this big.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was small. But did you play games while we were away? What did you do?
Well, I was hoping to have finished
well.
A Link Between Worlds. And let me tell you, the game is pretty easy. I didn't look at... Boy, it's got a weird kind of bitterness to it.
Yeah, it's nice.
You know, I need a break from it. It's really rich and then bitter.
It's lovely.
Just like my first wife.
Mmm.
But... A Link Between Worlds. I was hoping to have finished that. Remember, I was trying to finish it to mm-hmm. give it to you mm-hmm. so you wouldn't have to play Fallout Shelter. and then my Lackridge Spinder got all tangled up. You're not even listening anymore.
I am. You're a Lackridge Spinker.
So I tried to finish that game, and I didn't make it. And then I had to look at an FAQ.
No.
I couldn't find all
you
the ore.
You hate doing that.
Yeah, I don't know. But the thing is, it's like I'm not going to sit around here for four nights not knowing. I just got to know and I got to move on. You know? So I looked.
Are you depressed about this?
No, it just made me lose it. I fall out of love with a game when I have to look at an FAQ. Okay?
Oh, really?
Like, that's a fact. I just want... As someone who's been playing games since I really... A kid, like
mm-hmm, yeah.
like a 7-year-old kid, I should be able to figure these games out. And if I can't, that's when I just feel like that's the jump the shark moment for video games. So I don't know if you have any bias towards FAQs. I mean, at this point,
I love
them. Once I look at an FAQ, I know a lot of people do.
I really do.
Once I look at an FAQ, the contract between me and the game is over.
Okay.
It's kind of like you're dating someone, and then you have to. Cheat on them to figure out how to please them. Like, what if I had to look up where the vagina was when?
No. But you're not cheating if you.
You know,
to
I'm
look
trying to make a metaphor.
No, that was. Yeah,
I think it's. I think on most women, it's here.
Okay, that's good. I've been looking at it.
Oh, you guys.
It's like that. That's where my last FAQ told me it was.
So, but you're not okay. But if you, that's a really interesting analogy. I like that analogy a lot.
But you just look at them willy-nilly. You're like, woo, FAQ!
Yeah, I really enjoy FAQs, especially when it comes to anything Zelda, because sometimes you just need those things.
No, you don't.
Yeah, you do.
You've been playing games for years.
If the game
makes you get an FAQ, the game's failed.
No, that's not true. People put a lot of time and work into these things.
Well, maybe too
and
much,
a lot
then.
Of love. And I don't mind looking.
You're smart. I'm saying that in public. I want everyone to know that I think you're smart.
So you don't want me to look at them.
I think you should be smart enough to figure out these
you
games.
You know what? I am smart, but I am not patient. And I think that's my main fault when playing video games is because even after I fail at one boss twice, I'd say twice is pushing it, I'm furious. And I need to know how exactly to beat this boss right now or I don't want
to
play it anymore.
Welcome to the world of Bloodborne. Because in the world of Bloodborne, you will fight bosses... Not 10 times, not 20 times, not even 30 times, but 50 times.
No, that is not something that I would
enjoy. And you'll get a little closer, and you'll get a little closer, and your heart will be pounding, and you will have knocked over your Doritos, and the cats will be like,
your
we're
Doritos.
Moving out, we're packing little bags, we're going to the hotel. And then you beat him, and then you know what? Oh, it's better than finding a woman's vagina.
Oh.
It really is. It's the best. It's the best.
Know.
It's the best.
So you'd rather be in a relationship where you win at Bloodborne than a relationship where you have
vagina. Yeah, I mean, I think that's true of any of relationships, too. I think it's true of everything in life. Like, I want a job. I want a relationship. I want things that really push me. I want them to push me. And then when I get it, sweet victory.
Yeah.
It feels like sweet victory. It doesn't feel like, oh, this is something I just looked up on the internet. Beepity.
Yeah, but sweet victory doesn't last forever, and those things usually go south.
What do you mean?
Relationships.
Okay, you the relationship portion of today's show.
See, that's why you need, I don't know, I just feel like having a little help along the way is okay, because even in relationships, like, you do need, maybe, it's like, you know, you go to counseling or whatever it is, like, you do.
Counseling?
Yeah.
You just get in there and you roll up your sleeves and you figure it out.
No, some people need help.
No, well, they shouldn't be together then. There's a lot of other people out there.
No.
Go try those people.
No, you should. Okay.
Try to find their vaginas.
Okay. I think the line has been blurred.
Try to find their Lackerspeen Day.
Your Lackerspeen Day. Blake has something.
Lackerspeen Day.
What do you got, Blake?
Vagabond Nights wants to know if Scott has finished Bloodborne yet.
No. I actually started over again, Vagabond Nights. Can I call you that?
Yes, you can.
I actually started over because.
Why?
Well, you know, Jason was playing it, and now he's obsessed with it. And
this is his friend Jason.
Yeah, my friend Jason, and Jason started playing it, and all of a sudden I was at like level 75, and Jason just like he's like I'm 78. I'm just like he's had it for like 4 days, and he's already level 78. Yeah. I'm like, that's weeks of work. And then I went back to the game, and I got kidnapped by a guy.
Whoa.
He literally grabbed me and put me in a bag, and then I woke up in this Netherworld. Oh, I love this game. I'm kind of playing it in my mind right now. Anyway, okay. I didn't know what to do, and these creatures kept killing me in the Netherworld, not once, not 10 times, not 20 times, not.
But 50.
I just thought, I don't even know how I got to this Netherworld. I don't even know where I am anymore.
So this is a completely different experience than what you had when you first started the game.
Yeah.
Months ago.
I just went back to the beginning. You know, the other thing is, like, I'm going to say something I probably shouldn't say it, but I was really sick last year. My brain is still healing. And the beginning of this game, my brain was still not quite healed, and I don't remember everything. Mm-hmm. But going back and revisiting these things and seeing them again, and also feeling how powerful I've gotten, how good my skills are. I mean, I have mad skills playing video games. But why are you guys laughing?
I don't know. I played you in Mario Kart.
Did you?
Yeah.
When did we play Mario Kart?
We played that last Mario Kart game together.
We did?
And I beat you.
On what, the DS?
No, on the Wii U.
Yeah, you never friend me on the Wii U. I don't even know who your friend is. What do they call yourself?
I know, I'm not friends with anybody.
You know, you sound like me.
I know.
And said Vic's friends for everybody.
With everybody,
both of, he has enough friends for both of us.
It's true, yeah. I don't have any friends on my Wii U. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I guess we can be friends.
Anyway, I started over, and I was feeling cavalier, so I started off with my skill level. You can pick, you know, what you are. You're like, oh, you're, I don't know, you're a noble, you're a soldier. I went with worthless bag of skin.
Worthless bag of skin?
Yeah. And it was just the lowest, weakest one, and I thought, oh, this will be fun, because I know I'm good now. My skills are, I'm just like,
So worthless bag of skin is the hardest.
Yeah, but the only difference is it just doesn't give you as many blood echoes at the start of the game.
But you need blood echoes.
Yeah, but I can go farm them. That's the funnest part, is going to farm them.
Well, you know what? You can also farm in other games.
The way you farm chocolates.
Yeah, anyway.
Lackerspeen Day.
Lackerspeen Day. So, I like the cutesy farming games, obviously, not so much Bloodborne, so I'm just going to stay away from it. I love that you love it so much, though, that it makes you happy that you're having a video game.
It feels like an adult game. Like, it feels like a mature game. It's a game that doesn't hold your hands. There's huge parts of it. You know, I don't like ambiguity, but in Bloodborne, you kind of have to just get comfortable, cozy right up to the ambiguity, because some of this shit's never going to make sense, or it might make a little bit of sense towards the end. And having Jason, you know Jason, having Jason play it, you know, and, you know, having our other friend Brian has been playing it a little bit too, and having these guys talk about it, and these guys are gamers, having them figure out some of these things for me is just immensely gratifying. And I do think it's kind of, it's a solo experience, but I think the socializing that you do in the game happens with other gamers who are playing the game at the same time.
Okay.
You know,
I just feel really left out. Like, I feel left out.
Yeah, you don't want to play, though.
No, I don't. I don't feel left out enough that I feel like I feel compelled to play, because I know this is not the kind of game that I'd be into at all. It would just frustrate me to no end. And I really don't want to have gray hair yet, and I feel like this game would give me a few grays, so I'm gonna stay away from it. But I love hearing your stories about it.
It's really for men.
Okay, that's
what?
Not.
Did I offend you?
You're offending like 50% of the gamers out there.
I only wanted to offend you.
But that's true.
Her testosterone level is like here. Mine is like there.
It's very true.
Yeah, of course. But the thing is, I want to finish the single player game before I get, you know, and starting over again. Now with all the games that are coming
again,
in,
honestly, I can't.
I don't know. I think it's worth it.
What level are you now, then?
I don't know. You know, I farm blood echoes like a motherfucker. I'm 25 or 30, so.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Probably, you know, even I'll go home tonight and probably 50.
Are you going to have your Lacos feed in with your Bloodborne?
I don't know if they go together. We'll try. Why? We'll try. Are you happy to be back?
I'm happy to be back.
Did I'll you
be
sleep happier, in your own bed?
I'll be happier when I sleep.
Oh, you didn't sleep? Did you just get home, like, now?
Well, I got home at, I was home at 2 a.m. I was home at 2 a.m.
Which but was then, what like, time I do my, in Sweden?
It was, like, it would be 11 a.m. Mm-hmm. Or 12?
Was your apartment any different?
No, it was okay. I always love when I come home and I remember that I did a little bit of cleaning before I left. It's nice to come home to a clean space. I destroyed it completely with all my stuff. I like dumped all the candy out and my clothes everywhere now. Mm-hmm. And but the thing I like to do when, I don't know if you have a ritual when you come home from traveling for a while, but I love...
Just feed the cats, go to bed. That's my ritual.
No, no. There needs to be food involved with me, of course. Like you can't, there's no comfort unless there's food. So I always make a pot of soup. Like I will always have... soup. So
even
before
it's
I go,
3 o'clock in the morning?
Yes, for sure. I will. Like, I need to have a bowl of soup, and that's like. So I always make sure. So I had some stock, a lot of soup ready to go before I came back. Like that was my preparation for the trip. Always come back to soup. It does. It warms your stomach.
So what do you do? Where's
it makes
the
you
soup?
Feel like you're home.
So what do you mean? How, there was you left food in your refrigerator for two
no,
weeks?
No, it was a canned. It was like one of those delicious vegetable ones from what's that chef's name? Wolfgang Puck.
You know, weirdly enough, in Bloodborne, one of the collectibles that I don't understand is a can of soup from Wolfgang Puck.
Really?
Like, what do I do with this? Jason, Brian, you guys got to tell me. Like, is this, what can I use it for health? Can I upgrade with it?
But then
it's
when...
That's right. I'll have Marissa look
but
for
it. But when you do that, when I start eating, I feel like I need to keep going because I'm a fiend. So then I looked at all this chocolate. I dumped all the chocolate on the bed.
I think you're an addict.
Probably. But I was so tired that I fell asleep beside the pile of candy. So I just woke up with like this pile of candy beside me. It was I feel like it was a nice thing to wake up to, though.
You know, that's embarrassing.
It's not. I don't know.
But listen, I got to tell you something. Yeah. That probably, you know, I'm morose. I don't know if you guys can tell from watching the show.
You are morose.
But thank you for laughing and thanks for putting up with my morosity. I don't even know that's if that's a word. But listen.
Yes, you do.
I had a really fun time, speaking of being in bed with candy. I got into bed with candy. I had a big bag of licorice, and I don't need to tell you what kind.
You love
black.
You love licorice.
I got into bed with a huge bag of black licorice, and I played A Link Between Worlds, and I'm eating it, and I'm just playing.
Isn't the licorice from like 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, I didn't eat it. Yeah. But I was so happy. I couldn't believe it. I just couldn't believe what I discovered, that I could get into bed and play this incredible game and go into this world that I was in love with and eat this comfort food that, you know, especially this time of year with rain falling and everything. Yeah. And then I got cats on top of me. It's like, what else do I want? Like, this is it, right?
That's you at your happiest, eating a bag of licorice with your cats all around you.
That was, I mean, it just, when you were saying you woke up next to a pile of candy, it just reminded me of that.
Did you fall asleep with the candy beside you?
Why would I fall? There's candy beside me. I'm not going to fall asleep, and I'm not going to not fall asleep while there's still candy to eat. I don't have a whole bed filled with it.
I had a whole bed filled with candy. I took some photos of it. We had a little photo shoot.
And what'd you do with the photos?
They're private.
Oh, they're just private. Okay. I don't know. Well, you're on Instagram. I'm not Instagram.
No, I did Snapchat one of the photos because it was at 3 a.m. Like, 3 a.m., why am I counting candy? Like, I should be sleeping. But no, like, I had to take stock of all of my treats. It was like Halloween for me. You know, you come back from Halloween, which is coming up, by the way. You just come home and you dump everything out. You get so excited and you put the things aside that you don't want at all. I don't know why people give you those. You know the Halloween treats that you get with like the, it's like an orange wrapper. There's like ghosts and stuff all around it. Don't give people that shit. It's terrible. It's disgusting.
What is it? It's orange wrapper with ghosts all over it?
Yeah, like the ones, like the cheapy candies that you buy in like the bulk stores.
It's all the way.
I know, I do, which is a waste for me. I don't want to throw away candy.
Who cares? You don't want to eat it. It'll make you sick.
I know. So I put that aside. And then you get the mini chocolate bars. Do a little pile of the mini chocolate bars because those are the best, too. And then when people give you bags of chips, oh, my God. Those are your favorite houses. I feel like you need to go out again for Halloween. I might be... Don't. We're going to get chocolate everywhere. Vic, we're not getting chocolate everywhere. Don't. Okay. All right. So...
cheap tricks are the best ones to know how you're not 200.
Oh, yeah, I really should be, I guess. But that's why I tried to start counting calories, as Scott pointed out.
I know, I didn't know it was private.
Before, just because, you know, as we get older, it's harder to maintain that. Because I used to, like, when I was a teenager, I would just eat, like, huge Costco-sized bags of chips.
I know, and, but
like,
when you show me pictures of you when you were little, you were this skinny.
I know, I was super skinny. Yeah, I was a stick, so I had, like, this big head on, like, this stick body. So some people call me Lollipop. That was nice.
It's nice. Thank you, people.
Yeah. So, no, now that I'm getting older, like, your metabolism does slow down a bit, and I do find that I snack too much. Like, food is such a comfort for me that I snack a little bit too much, and when I bake, I eat a little bit too much of the things that I've baked, so I try to give the things away. So, I decided that with all this candy that I purchased, that I would only eat, like, a small portion of it and give the rest away to people that I love, like you, Jones, and like you, Blake. And
but I think that's a danger, though, because you come to work, and you show up, and you're like, guys, look, I baked this for you.
Yeah.
But I know there were two other pans that you ate the night before.
Okay.
That's what you tell us.
Two other pans. There was one other
Well, pan. I don't know. I was just trying to exaggerate for effect.
I ate one pan. I gave the other pan away.
Yeah, that's right.
The first pan has to be a tester pan.
Listen.
I need to make sure it's good.
You have a disorder. And I'm glad you're being open about it, because that's the only way you can get help. So
I don't know if,
we're going to get you help.
If it's a disorder, if it's just being human.
Well, I think it's a disorder. I don't.
But you just said it.
No, I don't. You know, the thing is, I'll tell you this.
What?
Most of the snack things that I eat.
Yeah.
I don't even really like them anymore. I just eat them because they feel like some kind of reward, like something I shouldn't eat. They're forbidden. I don't really drink anymore. I have a beer at Christmas. That's it. So I don't have any sort of guilty pleasures. So I don't know. Like, if you really are honest, I was eating a lot of ice cream for a while, and then one night I'm eating ice cream.
You're eating ice cream every night.
I was eating ice cream every night, but then it's like, I don't even like this. I'm not even enjoying it. It's not even fun.
You're right. It does come to a point where
I was eating it.
A lot of chips.
Like, I get a bag of chips.
You get annoyed with it, sure.
And I would just keep eating chips. I'm like, I'm not even enjoying these. They don't even taste good, and they're just salty, and I'm still eating them because I don't want them here tomorrow. Is that the reason why? Like, why did I buy them?
Sure.
You know? So I feel like, you know, I'm like 1 year older than you, but I feel like I've lived long enough to have a little extra kind of filter that you don't have yet. From experience, that extra year that you don't have, you'll get it eventually. When you can think ahead and you're like, oh yeah, the last time I got those, I really didn't enjoy them and I wondered why I got them. But you just go in, you're a fiend. I've seen you pick up chips at the store. You're like,
at the store. That's not accurate.
She makes that face.
No, I do check. I do try to check, like, the ingredients on everything that I pick
up. But what's the point?
The point is because I know all shit. It might as well not be terrible
for me. You binge on poison, or if you binge on things that are slightly less poison.
Listen,
still
so
all
a couple
poison.
A couple years ago. This is a true story. I decided that I was going to stop having gluten, dairy, and sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And it was very difficult. It was very difficult, but I did feel, and I felt, looked better than I've ever looked in my life and felt better than I've ever felt in my life, except for when it came to eating something, because I felt like I was miserable. I was so miserable because it was so hard to find these things that didn't have anything else, and also still try to be healthy, but there was no happiness there because I still find so much enjoyment in dessert and in having those moments in baking. And I just feel like also I come from a big Italian family, and when we bond over food. Like, this is something that we do together. And whenever I'd go to my nana's, they'd be like, no, sorry, nana. Like, I can't have your pasta. I can't have your, like, I couldn't have anything that she was making for me. And I felt awful about it. Like, you don't want to do that to the people that you love either, because that's also an expression of their love when they cook for you. So I don't know. I just feel like we need to live our lives, and I if I get enjoyment out of this, why can't
yeah,
I
yeah, but
do
you
it?
Get enjoyment. Anyway, I don't want to talk about this here.
Why?
Because I'm just going to say something you're not going to want me to say.
Okay.
You get enjoyment, but then you also feel so terrible afterward.
I do feel bad.
Yeah, and it's like, I don't like seeing you go through that. And I like, you know, it's like then you wake up, you're like, oh, I ate all this stuff. And it's funny because I'll say, oh, we had a fat night. You're like, oh, I really did have a fat night. And then we got to go to Grouse. And then we got to suffer. And then we got to, and then we go and buy more chips. And then it starts all over again.
Yeah, but it's
so unhealthy.
It's unhealthy, but it's a little bit of a fun game when we do go.
It's not fun.
But I should say that this is the first time I've gone away for work and that I've actually used the hotel gyms. I've never done that before.
How many times?
A lot.
Twice?
No, a lot.
Really?
Three times in Sweden and three times in UK.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, that was it was hard for me to do. But you do it because I knew the night before that I ate like an asshole.
I was going to say you don't look as fat as I thought you would look today. So the hotel gyms really worked. So congratulations.
Yeah, except in the last one, my IKEA hotel, there were these two Swedish dudes and they were just like, what are like, I hate when guys are in the gym just like they're not even doing anything, but they stink. They I don't know if they came from somewhere else and why they smell so badly.
Europe.
But they're like, don't even, one guy wasn't even doing anything. He was just sitting on the treadmill. I'm like, can you just move? Because I need to use this. Like, I felt like I was being a bitch.
I was at the Y yesterday and a guy got on a treadmill right next to me and he reeked.
Yeah.
And I couldn't even work out anymore. And I was right in the middle of my run and I got off and I said to the guy, the attendant, I said, that guy right there really stinks. And he's just like...
You always do that. You always call people out on their...
We're all supposed to walk around politely, just pretend he doesn't stink. Just say something to somebody. I don't know if he's going to do something, but I feel like I need to say my piece. Mm. Did you say anything about these two guys?
No, because I thought they were going to be done soon because they weren't doing anything.
And smelly people just linger. And that's just like their smells.
There's a window and I can see the guy that's not doing anything, just like sitting there watching me run. Like, what? Can you go? Like, just vacate?
Did you have on some tight pants?
I
like wearing
on.
Tight pants at the gym.
I had my leggings on. I didn't realize that I only brought one pair of leggings, though, and these are the leggings that I travel in, so I did stink up those leggings.
That's
so
enough.
I have to get those washed.
Listen.
They smelled really cool.
Any updates on the toilets from Europe?
You know what? I used to hate the toilets from Europe, but now I think they're okay.
Well, I mean, I think they have come a long way in the last 20 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't... Everyone's pretty clean, I would say. Stockholm is really clean and beautiful, and I highly recommend.
The taxes are high, not as high as Canada.
But everything is very expensive. Yeah. Everything is very expensive. Like your average meal is, even if you go to a lower end place, your average meal is going to cost you like $25 Canadian a person. That's like low end. That's like going to Chipotle or something. Like their version of a Chipotle. But I need to say that I had Swedish meatballs on my last night. I had to have Swedish meatballs. I did everything the way, we went to a Scandinavian restaurant, so I made sure, I was annoying the waiter so much, I wanted to make sure that I had an authentic Swedish experience. So I had the meatballs, but before that they do this thing where they really like pickled things, they like pickled herring.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever had pickled herring?
Sure.
Okay, sure, so they do like a whole... They had a whole platter of like different kinds of pickled herring, and then you have it with a shot of something they call aquavit.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like a French thing, but so it's like infused alcohol. It's like, it must be 50 proof. It was really potent, but you have the pickled herring and then you do like half of a shot of the aquavit. It was black currant, the one that I had, and I felt pretty lit up from the one.
Yeah, your tolerance is terrible.
It's pretty bad. Yeah,
yeah,
I know.
It's pretty bad.
So I did that, and then I had the Swedish meatballs, and then I did a fika, and fika is a new term that I've learned, but I realized that I do it all the time anyway. It's when you have coffee or tea with some kind of sweet. So they really like cinnamon buns there. So IKEA is not off the mark. Like everything at IKEA is everything Swedish. Like you get the cinnamon bun. Also, they have the meatballs there. Also, they have the hot dogs there. That's what they eat.
I wonder, though, I don't know if you can even answer this, but
what?
I feel like going to Sweden to have the Swedish meatballs.
They didn't taste like the IKEA meatballs.
But I just wonder if they're just like, oh my God, this is such a fucking tourist thing. Here's your Swedish meatballs. Get out of here.
Yeah.
You know, it's like coming to the U.S. and just being like, we are here for American hamburger. We're like, I don't know, these things are shit. We eat these things all the time. They're like,
sure.
Oh, tourists come in. Here's the Swedish meatballs.
I mean, it was a nice restaurant. I think that a lot of locals go there.
Okay.
But I'm sure
just wondering. I don't know if it's true at all. It might not be true.
I'm sure it's a tourist thing that people go in and ask for, definitely. I mean, why wouldn't you? What else do you know of Sweden other than IKEA?
I know the Swedish chef.
I knew this, okay, but he's not actually really speaking Swedish, though.
Close enough for me.
But it's funny, their language is so interesting, because they just, like, they meld words together to make a...
How were the men?
Word. The men were dressed very European. And
no, I mean, were they hot? Were you attracted to them?
Was I attracted
Should I not
to
ask
men?
That? Is it inappropriate? We can circle back. Was I what?
When you went to Copenhagen, were you attracted
to
them?
The women were unbelievable.
Yeah.
Jesus, they're all, like, 7 feet tall.
Yeah, they're really... really tall people.
Well, they're healthy. They have a lot of vitamins over there. But listen, let's talk about some...
The water is very clean.
I'm glad you're back. Let's talk about some of the, and thanks again for the coffee. I really appreciate it. Sure. It's such a nice thing. You didn't have to give it to me here publicly, but Marissa does sometimes bring me coffee on trips.
Because it's something that you really enjoy.
I do.
And that makes you happy. And you seemed in a foul mood, so I thought that
I'm always in a foul mood. Okay. But listen, the let's talk about some of the news that,
Blake
that Blake...
Go ahead.
Akamaru 1987 wants to know what VR headset we would recommend out of the ones that we've tried. I know you've tried a few, Marissa.
Yeah, well, I just can only speak from my most recent experience, and that would be with the Oculus.
Well, there's no other... No other experience, have you? I've tried... What other one?
I'm sure I tried the Morpheus.
I played the Morpheus at GDC,
did.
And then I just recently...
PlayStation VR.
Oh, yeah, sorry. It's PlayStation VR. VR now. Whoops!
Okay. Thank you for giving us that update.
Those are the only two.
I don't know. It's too soon to say. I mean, just see how it all shakes out in 2016. We have a very busy gaming season right now. I mean, I'm kind of partial to the Oculus, but I haven't seen... I haven't seen the one that Valve has. I haven't tried it, but I've heard it's amazing. I mean, they're all amazing. The technology is still new. It's got to grow up a little bit, and it will very quickly, I'm sure.
Yeah, definitely. I don't know if it's one of those things that you should be buying right out of the gate, though.
Yeah, the early adopters will.
I know, and we will. But now, just because I'm seeing all these people, like, I'm excited about the new Xbox bundle that's coming out, and I'm really jealous of everybody that's going to be getting this thing. Because I want to have it. It just seems so much better than what I have right now. So I feel like that's what the situation will be with VR.
Yeah.
Right?
The big news today, of course, is that the new iPhones are out. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the new iPhones are out. I don't have one. Marissa doesn't have one. Blake doesn't have one.
I was going to go get one.
Were you really?
Yeah, well, we had to do the podcast.
Okay, I don't know if you're being serious or not.
So we're preventing Blake from getting a new iPhone right now.
Well, Jesus, just let's shut this thing down. But listen, I want a new one, but I don't need a new one, so I'm just going to stick with the one that I have. And I don't know what it is. Is it a 6? I have a 6, I think.
Yeah.
What does it say on the back?
I don't know. I had to put a dumb case on it. I have the 6, and I'm okay with that now. Yeah, I guess it's a plus.
Plus.
It's not an S. Yeah, it's a plus. I got the 6
the
plus.
The new ones are the S's.
Oh, man. So,
I
don't remember what some of the other news things were. Blake, can you feed me a couple more?
Yeah.
Yes, I can. I would be happy to. Something that was just announced recently, all of the Ghostbusters cast members are going to, all the surviving ones are going to be back in the movie. They're all going to have cameos.
Cameos, though.
Yeah. Bill Murray, Dan Aykroyd, Ernie Hudson, and Sigourney Weaver will all be in it. No Harold Ramis, obviously.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Or I guess he could be a ghost in it.
That's not that exciting. It's not that exciting for me.
That's interesting.
I thought the original Ghostbusters is okay. Like, I think it's watchable, but it's not, you know, it's not my favorite movie by a long shot. I thought it was a good time when it first came out. I actually saw it in a theater. That's how old I am.
Cult classics are your actual favorite movies of all time?
Cult classics?
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's what I mean. What? I feel like you wouldn't say that those movies are.
I don't know why everybody's jizzing everywhere over Ghostbusters. Like, I don't care. Sure, there's women in it, whatever. I hope it's fun, but I don't care. Like, I hope it's fun. I hope these guys have a good time making it. I hope everybody makes a lot of money, but I don't think
it has, everybody makes a lot of money.
I don't think it has anything in it for me, you know?
I was a giant fan of Ghostbusters as a kid, and I don't care about this new movie because I hate Paul Feig or Feig.
I like him.
I hate Melissa McCarthy.
I like her.
I hate all the movies they've ever made together. Her humor,
what do you mean? You didn't like Spy? We just watched Spy.
Her humor is so lowbrow and so stupid to me. So I'm so
I feel like she's smarter than what's written for her.
Why is this in the news then?
I don't know.
I thought you wanted to talk about it. No, I don't want to talk about it. No, forget. Let's move on to something else.
We saw Spy.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you didn't watch it.
I did not watch it. Was I supposed to?
No, but our review is airing. Sorry, when?
Next week.
Next week, yeah. But I thought that it was, I mean, I'm just going to say that I didn't say this in the review, but Melissa McCarthy is finally in a movie that is watchable. Like her
she's
last
always
movie.
In watchable movies.
No, well, Bridesmaids, yes.
What about the one with Sandra Bullock? I thought that was great.
That
was great. See that one then.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
What other news do we have, eh?
What else do we have there, eh?
Oh, you know, I got to say something. You know, we're talking about funny women.
Are we?
And Kristen Wiig is in The Martian, and that's all I'll say. Let's move on.
Yeah, she has she's in like three scenes.
I don't even know why she's in
totally
it.
Totally miscast.
Makes no sense at all.
I do love her though.
What
something that happened a couple weeks ago, but we haven't talked about it yet. Star Fox Zero was delayed until March.
Okay, Star Fox is delayed.
I'm totally okay with
it. I'm not surprised. I'm okay with it.
I wouldn't be surprised if it has something to do with the shakeup at Nintendo with the new CEO and everything.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like it's because you did a demo of it, just like I did a demo of it at E3,
yep.
And I felt like the mechanic was broken. Like, to me, I felt like the mechanic didn't work of the gamepad with the game. Like, something wasn't right there. Like,
What are the controls like in it? Because I haven't played it. It's like, you have to look at the controller to aim?
Yeah, you have to look at the pad to aim where you're going, but you also need to look up at the screen as well. Like, it doesn't work the way I feel like it should, and I don't want, especially when playing an aerial combat game, I need everything to work perfectly, because I'm already going to get nauseous playing something like that, so it's got to be.
I don't know if it's the controls, I don't know if it's the shakeup at Nintendo, but I do think it's a good thing, because I feel like right now is the dense, busy time for releases, for sure, and I just think it's so easy, and I don't know what kind of mode we're all in as gamers, but you know, like when we were at E3 in June, nobody was excited about the new Mirror's Edge. And I feel like there are things that are very promising, and they do seem exciting, and they do seem like things we want, and then they come out with very little fanfare, and gamers kind of turn away and kind of say, no, you know, now that I think about it, I don't really want that. Yeah. And I'm afraid that might happen with Star Fox. So I'm fine with them delaying it a little bit.
Yeah, but I think Nintendo games have a different kind of pull on fans. I think that they will, like, people that love Star Fox are still going to be excited about it. I don't think they're going to pull away.
I don't know. You have to remember, all these people are growing up too. Like,
for sure.
They're playing Star Fox, and they've been playing Star Fox for 25 years.
Yeah.
You know, so I don't know. So we'll see. That's a good news story there. What else we got?
A couple
things. What are you laughing? I want to just rush through this.
Story,
we got
10
minutes left. Okay, Catwoman's Revenge DLC for Batman Arkham Knight.
I feel like
the not here, so we should probably have that.
I know. Well, what are you doing?
I was sticking out. Look at you, had a third.
I feel like I'm so down on Batman. I don't think it's bad.
I didn't. So you know, Vic is watching. He's in the chat.
I didn't dislike it, but I just felt like it was just such a meh. Like, it was just so forgettable and so redundant.
That's not true.
Why? It's true for me. It's my own experience.
No, I just want. So wait, the Catwoman DLC. When is it coming out?
So you can play as a lady now in this boring game. Big deal.
Okay. You could
play as Batgirl before, and that was actually pretty sweet. But her story was so contained, like, it was just like a one-off. It wasn't, I just wish that I could have taken that character that I was playing with and actually
put her in a more exciting game.
And I mean, I'll play a whole game with just Batgirl. She's fantastic. Why not?
But I feel like a lot of people just kind of turned away from Batman too, myself included, which I just didn't expect at all. And I don't know, like, I feel like I'm trying to take the temperature of gamers right now is very difficult.
It's true. Yeah, you're right.
And I don't really know what their appetites are, and I don't know what they want. I guess I don't even really know what I want. So, good luck, game world.
I'm sorry, but jumping into that Batmobile is exhilarating.
All right.
It's exhilarating. It's so much fun. I'll just drive around Gotham. I don't care. That's all I'll do. That should just be a game.
It's called Grand Theft Auto.
Zing. Blake.
GTA.
Putting you in your place.
I'm okay with it.
What else we got?
This will be good for Scott, because I know you loved Super Mario Maker.
Weird thing is, a million levels of Super Mario Maker have been made. Weirdly enough, 998,004 were built by a little boy named Victor Lucas. Thank you, Victor, for those 998,004 levels. They're like more than most of them. They're all on like 99% are crap.
I went down the list of like the top 20, and 10 of them were
awful.
And so there's probably like only a handful of actually decent
just wretched, these brutal Rube Goldberg devices where you just go in there and you're like, I will build a level that will be impossible.
No, that's one of the rules.
Every single one.
It has to be completable.
Oh, I know they're completable, but only if you do everything exactly right.
Sure. Yeah. Of course.
So.
Yeah.
I was done.
I thought you were gonna love that game. You didn't love it.
We reviewed. It was on the show a few weeks ago. Where
I
you been?
I didn't see it. I'm
sorry. I've been in Europe. I was flying on an airplane for 4 to 8 hours, and then I was in the lounge and I got Walker's cookies.
Yes, a surprise. All of a sudden, Enzo and I were able to go into one of those lounges in the airport. It is pretty swank, and I took everything from the buffet. I went up like 3 times, and then I just swiped a bunch of those cookies, those Walker's cookies. That's all I have left. I ate them all.
Blake, what else we got?
Okay, Metal Gear Online, the multiplayer component of Metal Gear Solid 5, launches October 6th. Are we excited?
Moving on. No, I don't know. I hope. I'm sure Vic's excited.
You
know,
I didn't realize that you like Metal Gear either.
Yeah, I thought it was good.
Well, you know how I'm ambivalent about the game. I'm kind of bitchy about it.
Yeah.
Like, I kind of love it.
You're bitchy about everything.
There's things I don't like about it. I'm waiting until at least the multiplayer comes out before I abandon the game.
Yeah, you're the multiplayer guy.
Yeah, I'm thinking the multiplayer might be great.
Might be. I don't know. I think they did a good job. I think it's interesting. I know if you're into the fiction and the Kojima's work. What are you doing?
I'm showing off the chocolate that we just made.
If you're into Kojima's work, then you're probably going to be dissatisfied with the game. I know there are some parts of it that work okay story-wise and some parts that work okay character-wise. But overall, you know, I was surprised that Vic was as disgruntled as he was. Mm-hmm. He was very excited.
He only gave it a 9.
And usually that would have been at least a 19 or a 20 on the Victor Lucas scale. What else we got? Anything else?
Well, I want to know what you're doing this weekend. That's something. That
well,
I
we're still
know.
On the news. We still got we got like 5 minutes.
We have 4 minutes left on my.
Okay, we'll get to it. I thought there were some more interesting news stories.
Here's a good one.
I don't want that. You can eat it. I really don't want it.
Netflix just today announced that they're relaunching. They've ordered a new season. You know how they always revive shows that have been canceled.
Yeah.
They ordered a new season of the British sci-fi anthology series Black Mirror.
I've heard about this. Yeah.
That's the show. It was in the news again recently because the first episode of the show, it has the British Prime Minister fucking a pig.
Yeah. So I don't want to talk about this.
That kind of happened in real life, but we won't get into that. But anyway, it's like a Twilight Zone style.
I don't know. I feel like ever since Arrested Development didn't work, I've been a little down on it. Wet Hot American Summer gave me a little steam. Are you gonna eat that or not?
You were gonna eat it.
It kind of reminds me of what you're saying about Star Fox. It's like Netflix is digging up all these old cult shows and reviving them after they were canceled, but then it's like they get here and it's like, okay, well.
Yeah, they're not as exciting as you thought they were.
Yeah. And everyone, you think you want that moment to come back. Like, we all, you know, we were all nuts for Arrested Development. And then it just was such a, not a flop, but just.
It wasn't a flop, but
just
it wasn't as
great.
Exciting as we thought it would be. I don't know what else they could have done.
I really feel like these TV shows belong to a moment in time, and they have their moment, and it's very, very hard to resurrect them and make them come back and make them have that kind of meaning again.
Yeah.
And it's frustrating. And of course, you know, everyone's trying to save money. No one wants to come up with new ideas, and new ideas are always expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, people are going to keep doing this until, you know, the end of time. And so I guess my job on the show is to just look out for those things.
Okay,
and take them down when they got to be taken down.
Yeah, I don't know. There's a lot of shows, though, that have been doing well on Netflix that I didn't think would do well. So
New
season of The League. It's very exciting.
You haven't watched any of it?
No. New season of The League on Netflix? No.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm watching whatever this is.
No. That's your American Netflix.
It is my American Netflix.
We don't have that in Canada.
Wow. It's very good.
It's very easy to get in Canada.
Yeah.
You
could get it, Maris.
I'm just, you know, obeying the Canadian laws. That's all.
All right.
For the most part. Okay. All right. It's not legal.
So this weekend,
I'll do it.
Yeah, what are we watching?
Everest in theaters. Marissa's going to see that again.
No,
Martian.
Hold. You know what? That's something else we need to talk about really quickly here, Jones. Because when I watched that review back, I was furious with you again watching that review because you're so off the mark. That
oh, am I?
You're a 2 for Everest. That was not
oh,
okay.
Oh yeah, no, that
and
was right on the money.
I was.
That was a 2 for
people.
The 2 people who actually went to see it.
I was hanging out with some people in the UK, and one person who is very adventurous saw Everest and said that they loved it. And I think that you need to have that adventurous side where you would want to climb a mountain.
I climb Grouse every Saturday.
No, that's
and
not
sometimes
the same thing.
On Friday
that's
too.
Not the same. At least a full day climbing
right,
a mountain.
Listen, Vic has been doing this for years. We disagree on the show. It's
you're
okay.
You're just so wrong, though. Like you're just so wrong.
I'm not
though.
Wrong.
You're
you think you're right.
Wrong.
I'm objectively wrong about it. Thank you, Blake, for clearing that up. So this weekend, why don't we start with you? Are you going to run the vacuum?
I'm going to be playing some video games that we're going to be reviewing. I don't know where Animal Crossing Happy Home Designer is right now, and I'm.
I thought I sent it to you.
Yeah, I don't know where it is right now, so I'm just really sad about that.
You seem really emotional.
Yeah, because I need to sleep. That's something that I need to do also.
Well, you didn't have to make soup at 3 in the morning.
Yes, I did. That is my ritual. When I come home from anywhere, I need to have soup, or else what is the point? And then, so yeah, I'm going to be playing games. I'm going to be sleeping. That's basically going to be my weekend. Also eating.
I'm into football these days. I know that's not the kind of game we talk about here on the show, but
I got
this new thing, the Game Pass, so I can watch all the Giants games.
Hold up, you did buy it.
I did buy it.
Why?
So I watched. Why not? What are you talking about?
Cable.
I can't watch games on the East Coast on the West Coast. You can only watch like Seattle games or San Francisco games.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. So anyway, the Giants played last night. They won. They beat the Washington Redskins, and it was three quarters of interesting football.
So that's it for the weekend then, because you had a Thursday night football. So what are you going to watch on the weekend?
Well, I mean, there are college games tomorrow, and then there are NFL games again on Sunday and Monday. So I'm looking forward to that. Going back to Bloodborne, and I'm watching the League, which, as you corrected me, is apparently only on American Netflix.
Yep, it's true. I'm going to be watching the Blue Jays. I think it's very important to watch the Blue Jays. I've never seen so many Blue Jay fans before in my life.
And I feel like I'm okay just letting some games go at this point. Like, with my video games. I always have this big pile, and I mean, this is a new thing. I'm going to talk about this more in the coming weeks.
Okay.
But just letting certain things go. And I think that there are some games that you know, I always have a keep it. I'm like, oh, maybe I'm going to go back to that. Maybe that's going to be an important moment for me. Maybe as a critic, I need to play that. And then at some point, I just think, you know, my life is short. I got to move on. I can't play everything.
Yeah,
I
got to
let some of these things go.
Chocolate and chips on a Friday night.
Or maybe don't eat it and go to bed early, which is fun too, Marissa.
You know what, though? I feel like because I don't want to go to bed right now. I want to go to bed right now, but I feel like I can't. I got to fight it off.
Okay,
right? That's how you do it with jet lag?
Listen, I had a lot of fun today. Blake, what are you doing this weekend?
Yeah. Masturbating.
Come on. What material do I have if you're going to start saying that? I'm out of here.
Okay, fun.
Hey, thanks, everybody.
That's it? You're not going to say anything?
I'll probably play Metal Gear.
You're just packing up. He's ready to go.
I'm going home.
Metal Gear. Okay, and Scott's going to make coffee.
You're still playing Metal Gear? Have you finished it?
I'm waiting until the multiplayer comes out.
So you could maybe just not do... Maybe you could read. What are you reading this weekend?
The Fighter Pilot and the Deer Leader and the Fighter Pilot. It's about North Korea.
Okay.
Wow.
I read books about North Korea all the time.
I feel like you need your own podcast.
It would be interesting.
Thanks
so much for watching, everybody. Have an amazing weekend.
Thanks, everybody.
Get some rest, eat some chocolate.
Thanks for your time.
Vic's Basement would like to thank its sponsors, EB Games, Nintendo, Xbox, and GameLoft, makers of Dragon Mania Legends, which you can play for free right now.